All right, so this is part one of two for this piece I'm working on. So there's gonna be another part coming up soon, but today this is about how far we're gonna get. Anyways, I am building a liquor cabinet and it's gonna have a lift mechanism. The fine people over at tvliftcabinet.com, put a link in the description, they hit me up and they wanted to know if I wanted to use one of their TV lifts in a piece of furniture. I said absolutely, as long as I don't have to lift a TV with it. And luckily they were cool with that idea, so here we are. I would usually design something like this with pencil and paper, but seeing as I'm trying to get better with Fusion 360 and just CAD in general, I decided I would model this on the computer, and I figured it would just be some good practice. I also made a cool animation of the lift mechanism. I'll be waiting on a call from Disney after they catch wind of my animation skills. So even though I modeled everything on my computer, I still seem to be incapable of building something without putting it on paper with pencil. So I did a drawing there just to kind of get an idea of how much material I would need. And I was able to figure out that I could do the main two cabinets with one sheet of plywood and a few sticks of solid wood for the walnut sides as well as the oak cabinet door fronts. Now the trickiest part of this process was doing the bottom piece of the main cabinet. Essentially I needed that piece to span the entire depth of the cabinet, but I needed only the front part of it to be mitered. So I essentially did a stop miter, I guess is what you would call it. I think that should work. So now that I had everything cut to its finished final size, I needed to start thinking about the shelves and where I was gonna cut all the dados to accept those shelves. And once I had everything measured and laid out, I used the simple drill bit trick, which I made a video about a couple weeks ago. I'll put a link in the description. But I used that technique to cut every dado for both the cabinets, and everything fit really nicely. I had to plan ahead for the backs in each cabinet and how I was going to cut the rabbets and grooves for that. A lot of times with a cabinet, I'll cut a rabbet for the back afterwards once it's already assembled, but because of the way this whole thing is constructed, I needed a rabbet around the box, but then a groove down here to accept the back. And then on this one, I needed a groove pretty much around the whole cabinet, and then a rabbit on the bottom part. Just took a little more pre-planning, but I think it should work. Now that the cabinets were fully glued up and all the dados, rabbits, grooves, whatever else were cut, it was time to fit and glue in all the shelves. So with the main cabinets assembled, I then went to work on making these walnut sides. I didn't film the milling and glue up process, but here's a few shots of me cutting them to size. And as you can see, I wanted to get this angle here, as well as this big bevel. And my track saw ended up being the perfect tool for that. I then worked on mounting the back cabinet to the lift mechanism and the lift mechanism to the main cabinet. This was all a little bit tricky, trying to get everything to line up just right. And even right now, everything is being held together with clamps. So we'll have to wait and see if everything works out once it's all assembled. Finally, the last step was to glue up some oak panels for the cabinet doors and cut them to size. So that's where I'm at currently. Is it time to get a drink yet? Feels like it is. Oh wait, before we go. And stay tuned for part two. I'm gonna dive into all the little details in this thing and hopefully get everything buttoned up, and we'll get it stocked as well.